Before I talk to you, I should like to read you a letter from George Bernard Shaw to my mother.
Aye.
Does he
your says, father know?
The men of our country are being sacrificed by the blunders of boobies. The cupidity of capitalists, the ambition of conquerors, the lusts and lies and rancors of bloodthirsts who love the war because it opens their prison doors and sets them on the throne of power and popularity.
Now give us a song.
For the second time, peace is being offered to the sorely tired people of the civilized world.
I don't like the title.
At the close of 1915, President Wilson offered an immediate armistice to be followed by a peace conference.
Don't think much of the words, neither.
And in April of this year, Germany herself proposed peace.
How do you know? Got friends over there.
The exact terms of Germany's offer have never been made known to us. And I should like to ask Lloyd George what his war aims are.
And I should like to ask you what your old man has for dinner.
The politicians chatter like imbeciles while civilization bleeds to death.
Now you're talking like a traitor. Pacifists is traitors.
I ask this gentleman.
Oh, don't ask me. I don't know nothing. I'm stupid.
To consider the plight of the civilized world after another year. You do not know what you do. And the statesmen wash their hands of the whole affair.
Why don't you wash your face?
Old Douglas Haig's got them on the run. He's got them going.
Who tells you this? The newspapers who refuse to publish the pacifist letters, who distort the facts about our so-called victories. We are killing off, slowly but surely, the best in the male population.
Yes, their words to me.
The sons of Europe are being crucified on the barbed wire because you misguided masses are crying out for it. War cannot be won. No one can win a war. Is it your wish this war will go on and on until Germany is beaten into the ground